आगे जाके भी कुछ नहीं होगा
मॉर्निंग गाइस एनी मोर डिस्टर्बेंसेस यू वांट टू सेटल डाउन ओके इट्स अ नाइस सोलार डे आउटसाइड इज़न्ट इट came out it's nice and it's quite sunny over there and I do not know why I like this thing I like this climate over here probably I'm being most selfish it helps me in my business not only I get sales more during this season it also helps me to do my own R&D wherein I don't have to use an artificial light like halogen lamp I can use it in the sun I have my house which is the one of the windows which is facing south and they say that when you are dealing with solar If you are in the northern hemisphere, if the solar panels should be facing south because the sun is either going to be over Tropic of Cancer. I think. Okay. So it has to be facing southwards. Sometimes I always wonder. You know, my star sign is Aries. I've been wondering, is that the reason why I have? I don't know. It has driven me to something in solar. I do not know. That's all besides the point. Let me introduce myself and Abraham.
Once upon a time, Abraham.
Genie.
Once upon a time, more than 25 years ago, I was sitting one among you. And I just, when I give college talks, I just remember my background. After graduating, I worked for 17 years. That's an important thing which I just want to touch on a few things like work experience, working for company. You may be, most of you already have an industry set up. Probably your parents have already made it up for you and just have to take it over. But sometimes it makes sense to have the experience in the industry. And when you are fully measured, you can actually integrate probably what you are taking over from what is given to you. And do something of your choice. I didn't have that benefit. I mean, I had working parents and this was after 17 years of working, I decided that okay, I need to start something which was more satisfying to me, and that's why that's how in 2008 or 9, I'm not exactly sure when I started. Though I'm in 2009 over here, I quit my job and started something on my own. I have remained in the field of renewable energy because that is something which gave me a lot of satisfaction. This is the background of mine, which I just told you. I started it with a philosophy that let me sell something which is good to, you know, people would not ever curse me. And I feel it's paying. You know, I mean, somewhere when people talk or people don't talk, I know it gives me a great satisfaction. So that's why I'm in this field, right from 2009, wherein solar was just being heard. People still didn't know about it. Today, thanks to whatever factors, you know, people are now aware, and they are aware. They don't ask you, what is solar? Otherwise, I remember 2009, people, what is solar? Something like that way. Probably their school education, solar is connected with the solar system, or the planets and other things. What I'm trying to do in this 1 hour over here is that, in fact, I was told by the organizers that I am an entrepreneur. I do manufacturer. I'm a small scale SME organization. And I do something on my own. Now, I've also been told by the organizers that all of y'all are mechanical engineering students. And probably y'all want to relate something to understand. I mean, solar is typically an electrical or well, electronics has come into it. And probably, how is the mechanical part integrated to that? But I will be touching on some aspects of that. At the end of my slides, I'll be showing you some of my products, the pictures which are over here, and some of the products which I have kept it on display over here. Now, you must have all heard, I mean, I'm touching a little more basic. Some of you may be very familiar, you must have learned it in your lower classes. But I'm touching a little more basics till I finally, at the end, I will come into the products directly which is running on solar. All these products are running on solar. There's one typical product which I have not manufactured, but this is a Chinese product, which is working on wind energy. And this is something which I just bought it from the market just to show it to you. And from the mechanical engineering point of view, it's something wherein you people can sit and design. And what is this? This is, you heard of a motor and you heard of an alternator.
Yes.
And this, you keep it on my, I keep it on my car or my, I have a scooter also. I keep it on the side. And when wind blows on it, you see, it's a small light which will alert vehicles in the evening that, okay, there is something over there. Sometimes I keep this. I just brought it over here, kept in my car, I brought it over here just to show it to you. So what's this? This is no battery. Just that when the vehicle is moving a little fast, you have brighter light. This is, of course, something which can be made. This is on wind energy. Lately when I've been talking to people, still people are not very educated. People in the cities, they are more or less aware about it. But there are other people who are still not aware. So I thought I'll let me integrate the some part of the basics and then switch on to the special product what I'm talking about. Renewable energy is generally defined as energy that is collected from resources which are naturally replenished. I have my house, which is the one of the windows which is facing south. And they say that when you are dealing with solar, if you are in the northern hemisphere, if the solar panels should be facing south because the sun is either going to be over Tropic of Cancer. So it has to be facing southwards. Sometimes I always wonder, you know, my star sign is Aries. I'm just wondering, is that the reason why it has driven me to something in solar? I do not know. Anyway, that's all besides the point. Let me introduce myself and Abraham.
Once upon a time, more than
renewable because you can plant trees again, but again it's not advisable. So talking about actual renewable energy, sun, wind and biomass and other forms. There'll be one more product which will be of very interest to you, which is my slide. When I come to that point, I'll show it. What is non-renewable? That I think everybody is aware. Almost everybody is having a bike or a car or whatever it is. Coal, petroleum, natural gas, propane. Non-renewable energy is energy from fossil fuels which are made of carbon. It's believed that fossil fuels were formed 300 million years ago when the earth was a lot different landscape. It had swampy forests and very shallow seas. Now, let me tell you one thing. I mean, me promoting solar energy, renewable energy, there's always a mental war with those people who are, you know, using fossil fuel energy for your bike. Of course, I drive a car myself. I still don't have the pleasure of running my car on solar energy. But there's always a mental war. But that doesn't mean that that's absolutely bad. There are pluses and minuses, which you can see it on the screen over here. The good thing about fossil fuels, that is the only good thing about fossil fuels, is that it is still very cheap to produce. And that's where the fossil fuel fellows, the petrol fellows and whatever, all the people who are taking oil, they try to not bring in the solar energy over there by saying that it is very cheap. How can we invest in plants for solar? It's costly to implement. So since fuel is available, let us use that and we can run our machinery with that. But where the solar part people talk about is, okay, you are just burning the fuel and that is going to kill the planet. There's nothing going to be left for the future, for your next generation children. And that is where the solar people talk about it. The bad thing about fossil fuels are made of mainly of carbon. And they are burned, they use a lot of carbon compounds. They hurt the environment in many ways. Air, water, land and all consequences, pollution and consequences of fossil fuels. And that is one thing which you can note, is that not everything is fossil fuels in non-renewable energy. Things like uranium is also not a fossil fuel. Uranium, we are talking about nuclear energy. Just 2 days ago, I was talking to a friend of mine, and he says, and he is not very much in favor of solar, and nahi hoga, nahi hoga. He has always been talking to me for the past 3-4 years, kuch nahi hoga. But today, when he sees that the trend is happening, I mean, I know of being in this business for quite some time, the inquiries are beginning, the awareness is coming, people are beginning to talk about it. And he says, oh, I wish the government will put nuclear plants all over the coast and, you know, nuclear. I told him, philosophically, I am not in favor of nuclear plants. Because you might say that is cheap, that is efficient, whatever it is. But something from, as I told you, from a philosophical point of view, there are a lot of chances of misuse going to happen. I mean, today, being in Mumbai, we are always afraid, when is the BRC going to be bombed? I mean, if that thing, something happens over here, will we be victims of nuclear attacks and all those kind of things? Again, some people might say that, okay, rubbish, forget it. This is going to be very secure. But I, again, that's my personal feeling, my personal thoughts. I think you can, there are other methods of generating energy, which now the country, the government is beginning to realize, which we never realized in all these years. So, you don't have to depend on nuclear energy, is my personal opinion. There are other options also. What is solar energy? Solar is the Latin word for sun. It's renewable, it's considered renewable energy because the technology is used to convert sun's power into electricity. Does not produce smoke. Tapping the sun's energy does not usually destroy the environment. The drawback of solar, which is again not a drawback of wind energy, is that in the night time you don't have the sun. So what do? So then it involves a storage medium. A storage medium is a separate subject that is a big bone of contention, wherein the solar engineers are not able to move out so easily. You have to store them in batteries. Again, batteries also, there are poisonous forms of batteries. You have lead acid batteries, that's poisonous. Now there are newer forms of battery coming, which is the lithium batteries. The common thing, this, I didn't bring a single piece of the lithium battery, but this is a pack of 18 lithium batteries. In your common, in your normal life, you can see a lithium battery kept in your laptop. That's again in a pack. If you open that pack, there are 6 batteries over there, 6 cells. So that's lithium. Lithium is considered to be lesser polluting to the environment. I normally try to stick on lithium as far as possible. It's not polluting, but lithium is costly. But there are a lot of advantages. So the battery is the main bone of contention when it comes to solar energy, because storage is a problem. In fact, there are technologies coming, because nowadays, I don't know, some of you must have heard of something known as net metering, wherein you can, if you've got space on the top, you put solar panels, you generate the electricity, and you don't want to store it into a battery and use it for yourself. What you can do is that if you've got a lot of space, you generate it and give it back to the grid after using it for the daytime for your office or your house or your water factory. And you can give it to the grid and you can sell it to the grid. The government will pay you or offset the cost for your electricity bill. So those things are coming. It is just coming in Maharashtra. It has started in Gujarat and a lot of other places. In foreign countries, it's very much over there. So something known as net metering. Now, talking specifically about solar cells, many of you have heard about the solar cells, solar panels, other things. Let me explain. The solar cell is something which is it's a chemical chemical product. When light falls on it, it gives rise to electrons moving and gives rise to electricity. So that we call it as photovoltaic cells or PV devices. There's also something known as solar panels, which people in Mumbai are a little more familiar. It started much more earlier. You must have seen in typical bungalows that started that way. Now only we are talking about electricity generation. Solar panels are water heaters. You must have seen that in your houses outside Mumbai also. And that is an indirect form of using solar energy. It is not converting any electricity. So when you see a water heater, there's no electrical system in that. The electrical system is only for running a pump or a motor to keep the water running. But otherwise, there's no electricity generation in that. What the water heater is just glass tubes, and the water runs through that. It is with a lot of area exposed. And when water passes through that, it gets hot. So here, directly the sun energy is used for heating water, and after it's hot, it is stored in insulated tanks. So when it is stored in insulated tanks, you can use it for almost 24 hours, it remains hot, and that's how you get solar energy in the form of water heaters and other things. This is one thing which I got this picture and I wanted to show it to you. This is typically the parabolic trough. You know, this is I think more of I'm coming the mechanical engineering part of it. This shape is made in such a way wherein the sunlight falls on this and the energy is concentrated on this center line over here. So the advantage of that is the full energy is focused on the center line, and this is the water tubing. The water gets hot in this and it is allowed to pass on that and you get much more efficient. So this is a parabolic trough system with one kind of one such system over here. Now, this was the slide which I was talking about. Another form of energy which is renewable, which is not polluting the atmosphere, which is known as piezoelectric energy. Now just to get the attention of a few people, preferably from the back side, I think there's a lot of examination activities or I don't know what is it. Can you, somebody from there, give me an example, some form of piezoelectric energy which you have seen in your day-to-day life? I'm sure everybody has seen it. Can anybody put up their hands and say what is it? Okay, but piezoelectric, fine. Yeah, okay, fine. What else? Anybody else? Something more common. I mean, I use a Titan watts. I don't know whether it is piezoelectric, but something which will be different. Anybody else? Any other suggestions? Nobody? Can you think of something? Definitely everybody has seen it. But it is it's not able to strike you. And that's absolutely a beautiful way of generating electricity. No, I'm talking of piezoelectric, a crystal. Cigarette lighters? Yeah. Well, I was thinking about your lighters in your cooking gas, right? You all are too much advanced, you are talking about cigarettes. Okay, anyway. So that's the same thing. What you see in the lighter and your cooking gas is the same piezoelectric. Now what is a piezoelectric? It is basically, when you put a mechanical pressure, it generates an electrical output. Now, what is mentioned over here in this slide is that the research is still going on. People are not yet aware about it. And you are thinking that, okay, what is the gas lighter going to do? I just for giving a spark for my gas. There are much more applications and uses of it. I remember I attended the Tech Fest in IIT just a few years ago, and there was a research team come from the UK, and he put a huge board and there were piezoelectric switches. He made it look magnified because he was demonstrating it. And okay, he presses one switch, he uses mechanical energy, one light spark. Okay, now It's possible. It's mechanical energy, one light spark. I was thinking about something. As I said, my mind is always wondering where and all I can use it for generating. Now, I'm just wondering, this is some good thing. I mean, there's a lot of mechanical engineering involvement, a lot of final product creativity, and finally, of course, selling it out as a product. I was just imagining, piezoelectric crystals are available. They don't generate a lot of electricity, but a number of them will generate a lot of electricity, and they are very costly also. A good example of using piezoelectric crystals and generating electricity is a typical thing. I'll give you an example of your Dadar railway station bridge, which is always crowded right from morning to evening. Can you imagine if somebody takes the responsibility of putting these crystals on the pathway, on the bridge, millions of them, and do you have to pay people to walk on that? No, it's free. So when I walk on that, my body weight presses the crystals. And across the crystal, the energy is generated and it can be stored in some form or the other. Railways can use it. I'm just giving one form. The footpaths. Can you imagine the lights across your building will be lighted because of all you students are walking on that? So there are various ideas. Now this is still on what you call, people are doing research on that. But probably when you people are into corporate life after so many years of experience, this would be a common thing. I just brought up this slide in between because this is one form where I thought is also something which is very much in the future. Okay, now I come to my subject, which is solar modules. Now we are a manufacturer. I have my partner who concentrates on the manufacturing part. Me being the electronics engineer, I concentrate on the electronics part of it. And this partner of mine makes these solar modules, which I'm showing over here. I will be passing it on. You can pass it on and you can see it and bring it back. Now this solar module, these things are known as resin laminated modules because what the top surface you see over there is a resin coating. Originally it was made of polyurethane paint. Now, how do we manufacture these things? Now, that is where now I'm covering the aspects of your make in India. These modules are made in India. You get these modules from China, it's available. You can get it in bulk, whatever it is. But here we are talking about making almost 90% of the thing in India, except for the last 10%, or rather the first 10%, that is the basic cell. The cell manufacturing company in India is still not there. There is still scope. One of you engineers one fine day would be having a cell manufacturing unit which is made of silica. I'll be showing that procedure over here. Now the rest of the process, we are doing it over here. We manufacture this resin laminated modules using basic solar cut cells. This also you can pass it on for a few to see, no problem. These are cut cells, broken cells, and when you see they are very flimsy, like these wafers, you know, you can actually break it. And anybody wants to try break it, no issues, because these are all waste material, don't throw it out. But I brought it out to show you, these are the basic laser cut cells. Now these laser cut cells, these are cells, why I said laser cut means the cutting is using a laser to get the perfect square and the perfect thing over here. These are used laser cut cells which you are passing it on. Each cell gives out a certain voltage and a certain current, which you will see probably in my next slide over there. Now what we do is that if each cell gives about 0.5 volts, if I want to make a solar module, the module which went over there, I think it is about some 6 volt to 150 milliamperes. Now if I want to get 6 volts, all I do is I keep the solar cells in parallel form or series form, which is common. It is actually in series because when you keep adding voltages. And I arrange a matrix, I keep a matrix of that, and the whole thing, the cells, are kept on something known as Tedler, which is like your glass epoxy for those who do not understand Tedler. Now, between the cells, after it's kept in a matrix form, creating the exact voltage what you want to do, you use this material, EVA, which is heat treated, which forms the bond. So that's how your material sticks on the Tedler. And again, above that, also use the same material, which when heated, it will be a transparent surface for the light to pass in and will create the bond. And that's how the whole material is created, which is coming out, which I have given that single solar module, and I call them a solar module. That's over there. So if you see the difference on the solar module, if you see, there's actually a thin layer of the solar cells, which is the other box, which is coming out over there. This is a picture which is of the solar module which is circulating over there. So you can see that just this is a thin surface over here, and it is resting on the backside, which is Tedler, and the above coating is earlier used to be polyurethane, now you use even EVA. So this is what it is. The typical example of a 5 volt, 450 milliamperes. So we just for your understanding, this may be interesting for you people to know mechanical engineering, because the one thing which I've also been an engineer, and though I say electronics engineer, there are a lot of things in mechanical I still don't understand. But I'm sure my college professors used to tell there at that time, and I'm sure even your college lecturers will tell now, that you cannot say that, okay, you are a mechanical engineer and you don't understand anything about electronics. When you're working in an industry, you need to know what your electronics counterpart is talking to you, what your civil counterpart is talking to you. So this will be interesting for you to understand as to how do we generate this thing. Now you have one cell, two cell, three cell, four cell, five cell. That's how 5 volts are generated. 0.5 and 0.5 is 1 volt. So this is in series, and this is in, and the whole combination matrix form, you can get the voltage. There's a current also, how it is calculated, which will be there in the slide, which I'll show it to you. Okay. Now, the cells which are available in India, which is just passing on over here, they're generally 16% to 17%, which is available in India, which comes mainly from China, Taiwan, etc. As I was told that there's one company in India which is manufacturing the cells, but I'm not very sure about it. So most of this basic material comes from abroad. Whereas, if you buy a solar cell from the US, you will get it at 19% to 20%. Now, obviously, the question is that why can't I get the 19% to 20% over here? Yeah, you can get it. The problem is that there's a cost. There, people are looking for better quality, they can pay the cost. Here, if you want one piece, get it from the US. Because the Chinese fellows are not going to supply one piece to you, they want it in bulk. So the market trend is such that we have a little more less efficient solar cells available over here in the Indian market. Whereas the better quality ones are go to these advanced countries because they can afford to pay, that's all. Now let me give you some basic information of electrical for you to understand when you people design your own system. This is I definitely thought of incorporating this thing, because when I sell the solar cells, generally I sell it in bulk to people who want to use it and make products like these products. But there are a lot of engineering college students like you people who come and say, okay sir, we want this, this thing, I sell it on online on eBay and other channels. We want to have one cell, we want to have two cells. So we sell it. I mean, I said, okay, I can modify anything, what are the standard things available, this is the size, take it or leave it. But I realized that even at B level, people are doing the projects and all, people are still very ignorant. And they probably want a cell which is just 0.5 volts. And they expect the size to be big because their mechanical engineering design was that way. Or the other way around is that they want a higher voltage and they want it to be small. That's ridiculous. I mean, they need to understand that I can't help it. This is the solar technology. A certain cell that is available gives a certain power output. So if you want a particular voltage and a particular current, then you design your mechanical part of it, exposure in such a way. Don't I have people saying that we want this thing and large size. So that's where I have incorporated. So typical basic cell, that box is coming around. The statistics are 243 square centimeters give 4.1 to 4.2 watts of power in a 17% efficiency cell. So how is the 17% calculated? Basically it is the same thing. The power of the solar cell is what? That means you take 4.1 or 4.2 divided by the area in square meter. That means in square meter this becomes 0.243. So if you divide 4.1 by 0.243, you will get approximately 16 to 17%. So that is the efficiency that is available, standard available over here. So the reason I have written these things is so that you all also know that this is the calculation. So when you all do designs, your mechanical engineering design with incorporating solar, you keep this in mind while doing a calculation. Otherwise, you made your mechanical engineering project a huge thing, and then you realize that your solar is not chota jagah leta hai, or it is very big. So that is all something which you people have to think about it. Now that is where I was talking of the statistics about the cell. Each cell, the small one, which is approximately the size of a square, much bigger than that. If it is not electrically connected, you don't connect it, it gives 0.5 volts. And a solar cell, now this is again your calculation. These are statistics available from the solar cell that is producing. A solar cell about 17% efficiency gives 30 milliampere per square centimeter. So when you have these data with you, so when you know that okay, you want to have, so that is where you can calculate upon your size what current you can expect to be coming out of it, what voltage you can be getting coming out of it. So that's how you can, this is approximately statistics are given to you. Now coming to this statement, what is a solar cell? What you is coming in those box, those wafers? It's like a diode, wherein the p-type electrode, the positive electrode is on the top of it, the bluish color thing which I showed in the previous slide. And the lower type is the n-type, the negative electrode. That means your negative voltage comes out from the lower end and the top portion is the positive voltage that is coming over there. Now, I've talked here, I've written the slide over here, there are two types of solar cells available. But it is solar crystalline cells. There's another form of solar cells which I have not mentioned over here. That is the amorphous silicon, amorphous solar cell. Can anybody give an example of an amorphous silicon? Again, that is, you've seen it in common, almost everybody. Anybody that you can think about? What is all used over here is all crystalline. What I've sent it over here is all crystalline. But there's something known as amorphous. And you have definitely seen it. Amorphous is very low efficiency. If crystalline is around 17%, that is about 2%. That means if you want to have that efficiency, you need to have a very huge base. That's why amorphous doesn't sell. It's very huge. But it has got certain application, and I'll tell you what are the applications for. But can anybody think, have you seen an amorphous silicon solar cell anywhere? Yes, you're right. Calculators. Now the reason why it is used in calculators is because calculators do not consume much electricity. And the advantage of an amorphous silicon is that it can charge even in this lighting. And that's how your calculators start working even in your tube lights at home. Whereas the crystalline silicons do not charge in normal lighting. So there are people who want the best of both. They're saying that, oh, we want crystalline, but can it charge in tube light? I said, sorry, get your basics clear. You want to use amorphous? Okay, it might charge in this, but then it is going to be a huge thing. So it's not worth it. So, but there are certain applications. So calculators is only using amorphous. I am covering crystalline only over here. In crystalline also, there are two types. One is the mono and the multi. You will come across these terminologies somewhere down in life. And when you, now what is the comparison between mono and multi? There's no much of difference. But this is, I just want to bring up the point. If there is, if you consider the best of both the cells, you keep both the cells in its best performance, the mono crystalline is slightly more efficient than the multi crystalline. Now how do you identify? Now most of these cells which is also coming circulating over there are the multicrystalline. Because the multicrystalline is bluish in color, if you see the last slide, and the mono is black in color. Mono is a little more efficient. It's black in color. The cells that are available in the square format, unfortunately I didn't take the picture, the square format also, the multi is square shaped. Whereas the mono is pseudo square, there's got edges, cuts on the edges. That's how the market, it's available, the solar cells are over here, it's available over here. This is the way you recognize the difference between mono and multi. People,
There are people who come ask me questions also. आपके पास मोनो है या मल्टी है? So that's these are basic information which you can understand. Tomorrow if you are going to buy a solar cell from the market, you already got your basics clear. Now that is where I'm just covering this aspect. What are the manufacturing process of a solar cell? What you see is already manufactured, that cell which came in that box over there. Now how do I reach that particular level? The solar cell is quartz or silicon. Now these factories, unfortunately, I think there's only one in India, but they're all manufactured in other places. It's basically using quartz or silica. It is heated to 1600 degrees. And when pure silicon, actually I made a mistake while typing, it is 9999. It's not 99.90, it is 99.99. That it's available. That's why they also call it as 4N. That's why that N, 9999. So they call it as 4N silicon. Now when you heat it at that temperature, it melts into a rod known as ingot. And finally, when you get it into a rod known as ingot, you cut it into wafers using a diamond tool. And that is what is the thing which is lying in your hand, those wafers in a very thin format. But again, it is the basic format. You don't, I think what you are seeing over there are metallic tabs over there. So that tabs are put later on, just the basic wafers over there. Silicon nitride is coated on the top to avoid reflectivity and absorb sunlight. The blue portion is silicon nitride, wherein it absorbs, it prevents reflectivity. Otherwise, imagine sunlight falls over there, the whole thing is getting reflected. Now we need to absorb the sunlight. The sunlight has energy, and that is when you absorb that energy over there, it will make the electrons to move. You know, there is a form of energy, and that's how electricity is generated. The lower side is made of aluminium powder coated in the form of sintering. Now, this is something more of a mechanical engineering subject, where he calls this as aluminium sintering. So the lower portion, if you can, the cells are there in your hand, you can see the lower portion is aluminium coating over there. The purpose of that is to collect more current. Tin and silver paste is screen printed on the top like a grid form to create busbar connectivity. Now if you actually look into the cells properly, you will see that it has got some form of grids, which was the picture of the solar module I showed it to you. It has got grid. Now those grid lines are using this particular material to create the connectivity. So when you see next time a solar cell, now you already know what is the whole picture about all these, why all these lines. I also once, people used to ask, what is this lines there for? What is the purpose of it? So here's your answer. Okay, so now I'm coming finally to the my products which are manufactured over here, manufactured by me. Some of them are not manufactured by me, but I'm showing it to you. These are various applications. This was one product which we made it about a year ago, and during Diwali we had a very good sale. In fact, there was some person who bought about more than 500 pieces from us, and I remember just before Diwali, 1 month, Amazon and Flipkart had a sale, and they put a huge advertisement in papers all over the country. And one fine day, one of my fellow friends sitting in Bangalore, he calls, "Hey, you're selling on Amazon." I said, I read the paper in the morning, and I didn't know about it. And then finally, when I looked the paper, I saw my Diaz over there. Then I wondered, how did it happen? I was talking to my partner, how did it happen? Then we were just trying to recollect, okay, the Delhi guy bought this 500 pieces, he has put it up on Amazon over there. So this is something which we have created, and this is something which is one of our good products which helps, which sells, of course, during Diwali. Now you see over here, this is exactly the Diya with a solar module on the top. Inside this is kept the battery and the electronic booster. There's a small switch over here. Now we've tested it out in a normal sunlight like today. You keep it out in the sun. The next day, let's assume that, the beautiful part about the solar is that we created a switch, which means that when there is sunlight, in fact, if you bring this close to this light, it might probably switch off. I can show it to you. You can see the light has got switched off. That means this is there's a sensor in the system which recognizes, okay, there is some light, so we don't use the battery. So I'm being saved. So when I keep it out in the sun for charging, this light is switched off. And when it is switched off, in the evening by 7 o'clock automatically when it's dark, the light starts. And we've calculated that I declare 10 hours. I tested it out, it works for more than 12 hours. So if you keep it in this condition, during the daytime it is switched off, By 7 o'clock in the evening it starts. Say by next day morning by say 7 o'clock it will go off. And when the sunlight comes again, it starts charging. So you can actually keep it, if you have a nice place, a gallery where the sunlight during the day, just keep it over there. You can keep number of them, it will look beautiful. Applications of this is either you have a beautiful garden, you can keep it over there, or you have a home temple, you can charge it outside the sun and then bring it to your temple during the... Statistics, I just mentioned it for your information. What is the panel that is used over there is a 3 volt about 50 milliampere. The battery is lithium battery and it is about 1.2 volts, 800 mAh. The LED consumes 5 milliampere. There's an electronic booster circuit is used for the construction of this. Now this is actually, this should have been my first slide, because this is one of the first products which I had developed, we had developed. And I have been selling this on eBay since I think I started 2008, 2009. This was a solar cap which was selling on eBay like a novelty item. Even today also, okay, during the off season, as I said, no, I'm always very happy when it's summer season because my sales increase. The moment starts raining, the moment is winter, my sales decrease. So just 2 days ago also, this got sold on eBay, it comes regularly. Now this is a solar cap which was typically meant for, you can afford to do that, and people buy it for the children. Now it was meant for some other purpose. We thought, okay, the courier guy, the postman, you know, he may be feeling hot on during the day, so let us have some cool air coming over there. But I don't know, I cannot sit and talk to the courier people over there. I cannot talk to a lot of people. In fact, I have a project. This